Morning. Welcome on Facebook Live. I'm 1010 Win Sports Director Marc Ernay, and Kenny Anderson, the former NBA star, former Malloy High School legend, former Georgia Tech standout, joins us. You're on the mark, Mr. Anderson. Good to see you. How have you been?
I'm doing great. I ain't seen you in a while, man.
It has
since
been
my, what, net days?
Well, no, I covered you in the Nets days, but the last time we saw each other was at a St. John's game at Carneseca probably 3 years ago. So it's good to see you. You look well.
Thank you.
You're here to talk to us today about Mr. Chibbs, which is a documentary all about you. It premieres tonight at the IFC Film Center over on 6th Avenue. Mr. Chibbs has been your nickname for as long as any of us can remember. Where did it come from,
please? My mother named me that. It's very dear to me. She named me that when I was 5 days old. I didn't know my name was Kenneth until she registered me for kindergarten. So my family and my friends called me Chibbs, everybody. It grew on me. You know? And when I did something great or act a certain way, my mother used to say, look at Mr. Chibbs, Mr. Chibbs. She called me Mr. Chibbs. So it just stuck with me, and it's very dear to me.
Where did it come from?
It doesn't mean anything. She was eating. Her mouth was full. She said cheeks and then Chibbs, and it just stuck.
Okay.
Chibbs. It had a ring to it. And, you know, it was just unique.
All right, let's go back to the beginning of the story, at least as far back as we can go in the short time that we have. Malloy High School, playing for Coach Curran. What was that like?
Oh, it was awesome, man. That was my mentor. That's where it all started, not only basketball-wise, but the faculty, the school. It just, you know, I lived in that school from 7:30 in the morning to 9:30 at night. You know, I did my schoolwork. I got everything together because I know I had to go home. And when I went home, it just wasn't sweet at home. It wasn't a good environment for me at times.
Then you went to college at Georgia Tech to play for Bobby Kremins, who was a New York guy. How do you wind up in Atlanta?
Well, me, I wanted to go to Syracuse. I'm a big Pearl Washington fan.
Right.
Syracuse, I was 2 minutes from going to Syracuse. But my mother was like, no, I want you to go to Georgia Tech. And I'm a mama's boy, man. Mm-hmm. And I chose Georgia Tech. Coach Kremins is awesome. It was great for me. I picked the right decision for me was to go to Georgia Tech. Mm-hmm. Brian Oliver, Dennis Scott, Lethal Weapon 3. We had that great run, 1990, to the Final Four. It was awesome. It was awesome 2 years at Tech. I loved it. I loved it so much, I didn't want to leave my sophomore year. I wanted to stay until my junior year, but the coach pushed me out.
And he pushed you to New Jersey, of all places. Yeah. You wound up with the Nets, who chose you, I think, in the
number two
overall in 91. A lot for a young guy to absorb coming back home, I would imagine.
Yeah, I was the youngest guy in the league at that time, but it was awesome to be back home, to be in my old stomping grounds. Most of the reporters and everything, the media, who covered me in the Nets and all that, they covered me, they watched me grow in New York. So it was interesting. We had a great great core of talent. Derek Coleman, myself, Drazen Petrovic. We want to thank Willis Reed. He was the GM at the time. He drafted me there. So nothing but love for him. But I just don't think then, you know, the organization was stable. You know, we had seven owners. We had the gym. We practiced over at APA Trucking Facility.
Right.
We shared a locker room with truckers and all that. Mm-hmm. It was just it was just interesting. And then Drazen Petrovic died in a car crash.
Right.
Derek Coleman got traded, so I was on the island by myself. So it just, I had some great moments and some not too great moments in New Jersey. But all in all, I had to say it was great playing in the NBA.
You wound up playing for a handful of teams. Mm-hmm. What was your favorite city to play for and play in as a visitor?
Well, no, I give love to the three teams that I put my handprint on, and that's New Jersey, Boston, and Portland.
Right.
Those are the teams I played 35-plus minutes. I was captain of some of them teams, and it's all love. You know, but all in all, NBA has been great to me. It was a great journey. Played 14 years. Coaches was great. Players, relationships. It's a great life playing in the NBA.
Want to get back to the documentary, Mr. Chibbs. One of the first scenes, we see you talking about the greatest player of all time, Jesus.
Yeah.
Although you said in the sandal and robe,
he had to
maybe
get
not so good.
He has to take off the sandal and robe.
Right.
You know what I mean? He has to play in the uniform. So, no, that was a part of the documentary that I was just doing a skit for, a blog or something, and it made the storyline. So, and on that note, Jill Campbell, my director, with so much footage we captured over 4.5 years of me, and it's so tough to put those pieces together of my life in hour and a half. Right. So it was very interesting.
Let's fast forward. You were coaching a youth team up until about 4 years ago.
Yeah.
And there was a DUI arrest in Florida that I know changed things for you a lot.
It was,
but obviously things have improved since then.
Yeah, it was a wake-up call for me. It was a blessing in disguise. But mainly that, it just hurt me because I let those kids down.
Right.
I let the kids down, and I like to practice what I preach, and it sticks with me to this day. I am, you know, but got to move on, you know, and just pay. I'm just paying it forward. That's what this whole documentary is about.
Right. You had a trip. You kept your hand in basketball. You had a road trip, a pretty lengthy road trip. Yeah. You went over to North Korea with Dennis Rodman and a handful of other former NBA players. What was that experience like?
It was awesome. You know what I mean? It really was. They took care of us. Me, my ignorance, you know, I did some stuff with Rodman. We live in Fort Lauderdale near each other.
Okay.
I've done some stuff for him, and he's done some stuff for me. So we was like, he was like, yo, I'm going to get a trip to China. I'm going to bring some players, and you know, you want in? I said, yeah, I wasn't thinking about it. But I didn't, my ignorance, I know nothing about North Korea at the time.
Mm-hmm.
And I told my wife I was going to China, so she was like, oh, okay, cool. But I didn't know, it sounds stupid, but I didn't know I was going to North Korea.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when we got over there, they took our passports, they took our phones, and when we landed, we went to the hotel. You know, I like to go, each city, I like to get out and walk. Mm-hmm. It's so fresh air and all that. So I drop my bags and I run downstairs about to walk. And it was like, no, you can't move. There's no walk. If you walk and you hang out, you got to be with, you know, the guys that's guarding us. Because we had guards and people, you know, following us places and everything. So that's the last communist country. So it's very unique that I had the chance to Kim Jong-un.
Right.
I met him, shook his hand, and it was interesting. I got the picture, but my wife won't let me put it up in the house.
No, of course not. A lot of news going on with North Korea these days.
But on that note, though, we were just ambassadors of basketball.
Right.
Nothing to do with political. Right. I'm not into that. Since I retired, I go to China, I go places. We do clinics. You know, we interact with certain teams over there and the players. And that's what our main thing was. It was just basketball.
Okay, I know you're short on time.
Yeah.
And I'm just short. We're going to get to two last questions. Quick answer. Who wins the championship this year?
I'm going with Golden State.
Okay. And who wins a championship first here in town? The Knicks or the Nets?
It's a draw.
I put you on the spot.
It's a draw. I'm going with the Nets. I'm an ex-Net. But I do love my Knicks only because I'm a New Yorker and I want New York basketball to be great again. Even with the Brooklyn Nets and the Knicks, we are the mecca of basketball. We need our pro teams, the Knicks, the Nets, to play every night and to win and be exciting. It's just been a struggle this year, and it's sad for sports lovers in New York.
You following this stuff with Phil and the Knicks and Melo and everything?
Yeah, I do. It's out there on the news. But I want to tip my hat off to Melo, how he handled himself this year with the media. Very classy. Really good job, and it's tough on him, you know, but, you know, Phil and, you know, I think Phil was pointing and it made Melo the scapegoat, make everybody a scapegoat instead of just taking the blame and just working.
Kobe told me a couple of weeks ago it's growing pains. It'll take a while, but eventually it'll work out, you think?
No, not in New York. It got to work, you know. So we're not in L.A. and La La Land out there. This is New York. We got to win now. He got 2-3 years, it don't look good right now. It looked like we took 2-3 steps back. So it's not that easy.
Well, I appreciate your time. Kenny Anderson is on the mark today here on 1010 Wins and Facebook Live. Mr. Chibbs premieres tonight at the IFC Film Center. Good luck with the documentary, and thanks for stopping by.
Thanks, Mark.